Hello, everyone. I'm hoping this one actually comes through. And I'm hoping it does because I'm going to grab the URL and then go to, what's the word? Going to go put the link in the old chat. So let's see here if I can find it. All right. Okay, it's live though. I can see it. So I'm going to grab a link. All right. And then I'll go back and put it in the other one. Hi, everyone. Sorry, this is like so crazy. I've got to grab this link. Or if someone can go grab this link and go put it in the other one so people know that a new one has started, that would be great. So that would be great. All right, let's see here. I'll go put it in the other chat just to be sure. Sorry, little technical difficulties going here at the beginning. Sorry, I'm like having to use my phone to do all this. Okay. In a new live. Come join us. Paste a link. Okay. I hope you guys all made it over. Okay, we've got 151 people here. Okay, so you're really here watching now? I'm hoping. So we'll see here. Let me know in the comments if everything is coming through okay. Because I seriously was like live streaming, no problem, got no errors, nothing for like 7 to 10 minutes. And then I'm like, why is no one commenting on what I'm doing? It was kind of crazy. Oh, good. Yes, you see me. Good. I will put my phone away. That was so bizarre. Well, let's back up here. Okay. Well, like I said previously to no one, should have been recording. I did a poll on Instagram for which products you guys wanted to see. Did you want to see all two new watercolor stuff, some of their new stuff, or if you wanted to see Simon's a stamp? And I think 1/3 of you said Alta New and 2/3 said Simon. So we're here with Simon. This is one of their brand new stamps. This is actually one that I designed. This is called Botanical Split Background. So here we are. So sorry, I'm not sure why that live stream didn't work earlier. No idea. Yeah, I tried to find, like I started like 3 different live feeds trying to get it going. This is the one. I wonder if I should use my phone and try to go delete the other ones now because, let me see if I can. Well, you know, I don't want to delete them until I fully figure it all out. So anyway, I'm going to be using this background stamp to make 3 different watercolor backgrounds tonight. And this first one, I'm actually starting out with a little bit of a light wash of watercolor underneath the stamping. So we're going to be using some Sakura Koi watercolors. Obviously, I have not cleaned this up since Christmas. Hopefully, it'll still look okay. All right, I'm going to grab a paintbrush here. Let's use this one. It's a nice big one. It's a number 10 Escada. I'm actually going to get a paper towel before we get going here. All right. So I'm going to be doing a layer of soft color. Then I'm going to stamp and emboss, and then I'll do a layer of darker color. And I'm going to be using clear embossing powder, so I'm going to have like a different kind of color tone underneath. So let's see. Let's go from this pink shade, this kind of purple, like a magenta color. In fact, I'm going to just use my palette up here to make a nice magenta. Sorry if there's a glare. My new setup, my lights are right above me. This is how it's going to be for a while, guys. Sorry. All right, I need a bigger brush. grabbing a big flat brush. There we go. I don't think this brush was clean. Guys, it's just been one of those days. Okay, so kind of a light pink wash. And then we're going to go to this purple. All right, really light purple. And then let's go to this blue down here. This is a really big brush for such a small palette, but I'm making it work. Okay. I'm actually gonna go this way so the blue kind of seeps into that purple a little bit. I think that'd be pretty. I'm gonna add more purple actually. Trying to get just the purple and not that orange that's right above it. These colors do tend to fade quite a bit as they dry. So I am really not that worried for it being not as pale as I had hoped quite yet, because these will actually soften quite a bit. Okay, not bad, not bad at all. I'm gonna come in here, just put my paper towel right there on that edge. It'll hopefully contain some of that pink that was kind of going out of control. And I'm gonna hit this with my heat tool to speed up the drying. All right. Here we go, gotta dry this. Grab this little puddle here in the corner. Got a lot of watercolor there. Okay, so that is completely, oh, I just got it wet. That's cute, Christina. That's okay. We're gonna stamp over the top. Okay, so now we're gonna do some embossing on all three. Oh, you guys don't even know. I'm doing three watercolor backgrounds. If you're just joining me, I've had some technical difficulties this evening. So yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna have to remove this while I stamp. I'll come back to it and put it back on a board in a bit. Really like this background though. It's really pretty colors, color palette. Okay, so I'm gonna set this aside for a moment and we're gonna do a bunch of stamping and embossing. So this one that I just did, I'm going to be using clear embossing powder. And let's see, where's my Misty? Okay, so this stamp from Simon, the, what is it, Split Botanical? Botanical Split. It actually comes all put together like this. And you could take it apart, you can stamp it in three sections, or you can stamp it all together, you can do a bunch. I'm mostly gonna stamp it all together today, or actually, that's the only thing I'm gonna be doing. So you could actually do this, like all these techniques with any background stamp you have. Okay. Get this settled into this corner. Nice and snug. And then close my Misty. Lovely. Gotta move my watercolor brushes out of the way. In fact, I want to clean them off a little. Hold on. Try to clean these brushes. My little work area is much smaller than it used to be. Getting used to it. Okay, so I'll just put that right there. So when I stamp this down, it's going to be right over this area. I'm not going to get as much of the blue. In fact, you know what? I like the blue. Let's go like this. There we go. Okay. I'm using my anti-static powder tool. This watercolor paper is very dry since I just hit it with my heat tool and I had to dry it for all the paint to dry. So sometimes I actually skip this step of putting the powder down, the anti-static powder, because I think sometimes it doesn't really need it. But we're going with good crafting methods. I was going to try to go with mythology, but I can't remember. I can't, you guys, my brain. Okay, Versamark ink. Ink up my stamp here. All right. And I think I'll end up stamping this twice because it is on watercolor paper. It's a big stamp and I just need a little help there. I was looking for my Stampin' Bug, but I don't know where it is. It's missing. I'll have to find it later. Okay. Stamped once. Gonna stamp again. Hopefully if there's any areas that I missed that first time, they'll get some ink this time. Okay. I'll do what my friend Kathy does. She uses a rag sometimes just to help glide over the stamp. All right. I'm going to set this aside for a minute while I do my embossing. I'm using fine detail clear embossing powder from Simon. I've got my little drop cloth. All right. Ooh, that's gonna be pretty. Okay, you guys see that? Gorgeous. All right. I'm gonna funnel this back into the jar. Perfect. I haven't been able to find my coffee filters yet. So, usually I use a coffee filter to catch all that. All right, hit this with my heat tool until all of it's melted. Okay, you know what? Maybe we'll just go ahead and finish this one while we're going here. Okay, so I'm gonna put this back on my watercolor board. I guess you'll see that design on there. It's pretty subtle right now, really pretty, but a little too subtle. So we're gonna do a second layer of watercolor on top. And what that does is the clear embossing has trapped the one layer underneath. And now the slick surface of the heated embossing powder will resist any of the watercolor on top. So we're gonna have a lighter shade for the design and a more intense shade around. Okay. Lovely. All right, where did I put my watercolors? Here they are. Okay. Gonna get some more paper towel. All right, let's go in with, should we start the same direction as we did before? Start with the red pink shade. We'll just start here at the top. You can see how that resists the color, right? Love it so much. Okay. Now I'm gonna come and grab the purple. Okay, and then into that really pretty blue. Love how this is turning out. Getting more of that pink. All right, I think I'll turn it this way. Okay, y'all are starting a drinking game about me saying all right. Seriously. Let's see you guys do a live and not say words to fill the gaps. Just say it. Sopping up some of these little areas so that I don't have big, huge areas of color. So I'm just folding my paper towel so I get a new corner and that I can kind of dab into those areas and sop up color. Okay, we're gonna let this dry. I'll just let it dry on its own. I think we're gonna get some really pretty color combinations letting it dry. So I'm gonna set this aside. Now the other two that I have planned both use embossing. In fact, they're kind of the same idea, but one is just with gold and one is with white. But I'm gonna go ahead and show both because I think they're gonna have really cool effects. Okay, so let's see how I'm gonna do this. I swear I got two boards. Do I only have one for real? I'm looking for a board and I cannot find it. Oh, I moved it back here. Found it. Okay, we're gonna need this board for all of our watercoloring, so I wanted to grab it. I am drinking, you guys are telling me what you're drinking. I'm drinking a fizz drink. It's a Diet Dr. Pepper with sugar-free cherry mix-in. It's a soda. I don't drink soda often, but I'm spoiling myself tonight. Okay, we're gonna go back to my Misty. Get that right in there. Gonna use my anti-static powder tool again. Let's get that on there. And using Versamark ink once again. That's why I didn't remove the stamp or clean it, because I knew I'd be using the same one again. with the same ink. I actually probably could have moved my watercolor paper over a little bit. I'll do that for the next one. Use this rag again. All right, and I'm gonna stamp it twice like I did before. We've got some people drinking wine, ginger ale, bourbon. Awesome. All right, here's the second stamping. All right. I set this aside while I actually apply the embossing powder. If I can figure out where to put it. I'm running out of surfaces. Okay. We're going to start with some gold embossing powder on this one. So this is gilded embossing powder from British Monroe. Oh, it's so pretty going on. Cleans up so well. This is my favorite gold embossing powder. If you guys haven't noticed that it's like the only one I use. Sometimes I use antique gold from Simas' stamp, but for the most part, this is the only one I use. Okay. Hit this with my heat tool until it's smooth and melted. Might not be really smooth because it is on watercolor paper, but it'll melt. Okay. All right. Everyone, take a drink. Take a drink. All right. Sorry. Take another drink. Moving on. I'm going to stamp this one. Actually, I'm changing my mind. I think I will emboss after I watercolor this one. So let's go ahead and watercolor this one now. Using my tape to tape it down. Someone says, I'm waiting for Christina to say ta-da. Ta-da. Yes, I do have my little catchphrases. Yep, here you go. Here you guys go, saying drink. The comments are always like a little bit behind. I'm gonna need another Coke Zero. Someone's saying they put this background stamp in their cart and then took it out. Bad move. I think you're gonna love this and you're gonna wish you had it. Okay. I might do, okay, so with the gold, I'm thinking I want really rich color on the background. So I'm gonna paint a bunch over this. Going back to my watercolor set, and there's a green shade in here that is practically my favorite of all time. I used it a ton in my Christmas watercolor class. And I'm obsessed with it. So I'm gonna start with this green, and I think I'll go green to navy blue. I've been loving navy blue right now. I wish I had a room in my office, because I'm here at the new house, my new craft room will be kind of like in a loft area that doesn't have a door to close it off from the rest of the house. So I won't be able to do voiceovers for videos because I need it really quiet for that. So I have just a small bedroom that I've taken over as an office. And isn't that pretty? I love that. And but it's very small and there's no room, but I fell in love with this like green velvet chair, or maybe it was blue velvet chair that I really wish I had space in my office for, because it'd be a great nap chair. All right, and then we're gonna go to the blue. It's really intense blue. Kind of get those mixing. See that? Love that. All right, I'm gonna do a little more color. Ugh, seriously. You guys are going to break me with this habit, and then you're not going to be able to drink anymore while I say words. Adding more of this blue. And more of the green. And I'm going to set this aside to dry. I don't know that I want to hit it with a heat tool because I don't want to melt the embossing powder again. But I also kind of feel like I need to mix these colors right across the middle a bit more. Yeah, we'll see how that goes as it dries. I'll set this aside, and I'm completely out of hardboards. Dang it, I should have put this the other direction. I guess we will check on this one, see how that is drying and faring. See if we need another layer. I like how subtle it is. Does it need another layer of color to like bump it up? It might. I'm gonna go ahead and just hit this with a heat tool. It's mostly dry. And I'll just keep it moving. I don't want it to stay in one place for too long and remelt the embossing powder. Checking to see if this is completely dry. The way you can kind of spot check, and sometimes it's iffy, like you might mess it up if it really is wet, but if it's not completely dry, the paper will feel cool to the touch. And I'm only getting heat from my heat tool, so I think we're good. Let's do another layer to get more intense color. All right, starting with that reddish pink. It's nice magenta. Did I just say all right again? Seriously. Okay. Grabbing the purple. Another way to make sure you get really intense color is to try to get most of the water off your brush. Because if you take less water to the pan of color, it won't be as diluted. So bringing a really intense color or mixing a really intense color from the start is a great way to get intense color. Love that. And I think having just one more layer of color for the intense background behind the stamp will give me the saturation that I was thinking I wanted. Some of these areas that have a lot of color, I'm just gonna dab my brush in there and sop up a little bit of the paint. Okay. The paper I'm using today is Strathmore 5x7 pre-cut paper. I think it's 140 pound. I could be wrong. It's not super thick, like 300 or anything. I actually think this might look even better on arches, mostly because I just like the texture of arches more, but yeah. Ooh, the green and blue one is looking awesome. I'm so glad I let it dry, or I am letting it dry, just air dry. I'm losing some of the really intense blue at the bottom, but we're gonna do another layer and it's gonna make it even better. Maybe we'll just do two backgrounds tonight because the other one I was gonna do was just gonna be like intense color with white on top. But I think these two are looking really good. All right, oh my word, said it again. See, this is the way to make yourself stop saying words like that. Like if you say a lot, make it a drinking game. At least I have a drink this time. Usually it's just water and that's no fun. I'm gonna hit this with a heat tool, keep it moving so it doesn't melt the embossing powder. A lot of paint that has settled on the embossing, and I'm just wondering if I can pick some of it up. No, this is all pretty dry. Well, good to know. This background's pretty much done. Let's go back to the blue and green. Hit that with a heat tool, and then we'll put another layer of color on. I think this is pretty dry. Let's do another layer. Grabbing my very large paintbrush once again. This is, by the way, this is a 1-inch wide Zen brush from Royal and Langnickel. All right, okay. Seriously, I keep saying, all right, okay. That one didn't count. Grabbing a lot of that green shade and going right over the top. I'm gonna try to transition to the blue a little bit sooner than before because I feel like the blue really got lost and I love this blue. Dabbing off my brush on a paper towel so I don't have too much water in there. And because I really want to intensify this blue at the bottom, I think I'm gonna bring in just a little black. I think it will look awesome. Oh yeah. just really gets that blue. And then up to the green. With my other brush, the one that I was using earlier, I'm just gonna get it a little bit damp, and I'm gonna try to pick up some of the color that's on top of the embossing powder. It's got a lot of color going on right now, so I think it's just a little too much on top. It's a little too much to resist all that color. I really want to clean up this area over here. In fact, I probably could just go like that. And down here at the bottom a little bit too. Just pouncing into some of those little areas. Can you see that? A little bit of the color difference. Let's hit that with a heat tool again to speed up the drying. Got some areas right here in the middle. Just getting a smaller brush. I just want to clean up some of these little areas. I don't know if it's going to be worth it, but we'll try. If I re-wet it, because it's just the color that's on top, if I re-wet it, some of the gold color will peek through again. I do sort of like that distressed, almost patina look to it. We'll leave it. It's pretty good. We can take this off the board now and let's see what it looks like all finished. Lovely. And we'll go back to the purple, pink, and blue, which is all dry now as well. And here are the two backgrounds for tonight. I did plan to do a third, but I kind of like how these turned out. I love how those look. All they need is like a die cut greeting on top and you have your card finished. Okay, so we've been going for about 40 minutes. You know, once the live actually started for real. So anyway, I can answer some questions if you guys have some. Just gonna drink a little. I thought about doing a damp baby wipe over the top. Someone just recommended that in the comments. But sometimes that re-wets the surrounding areas that you're not trying to get. I guess we could try it. Let's try it. Getting a baby wipe. Let's see if we can clean this up a little. Oh, that's not too bad. It's not getting the areas too much. You know what? I think when I've done this in the past and I had bad results, I was using distress ink, which reactivates so quickly with a damp baby wipe. And maybe that's why I didn't want to use it. But look at this area right here. It's really muddled. You guys see that? I'm just gonna gently wipe over that area and see, it's getting the color off to the side. It is cleaning things up quite a bit, though. Good suggestion. I wouldn't have tried this again. Okay, I think that cleans it up a lot. I don't know that we need it over on this side for these. Maybe. Let's try it. We did so many layers of color that it just wants to stick to the embossing powder. Oh, I don't think that's worth it. It doesn't change it very much. See? It did change it very much. So we'll just leave that one. Someone's asking, why did I stamp and emboss the gold before the paint? Either way, it really doesn't matter which way you do it. Sometimes you can get some interesting pools of color that kind of surround the embossed area, and that could look really cool. So if you're going for a look like that, you would want to emboss first. But I don't think there's a real big difference with how this turned out between, you know, stamping first or painting first. I think either looks great for this one. Oh, someone's saying sometimes reheating can make the gold bright again. Well, let's try it. We'll see. Nope, that's not doing it. All that's doing is making the embossing powder melt into the paper, which is what I was slightly worried about. That can happen on thicker papers like watercolor paper. You have to be careful if you reheat it. I think on a regular cardstock that might have worked. What happened to the one with the three color wash and clear emboss? That's this one right here. Were you asking what I did to it, or are you asking because you didn't know that's what it was? Oh, some people are saying use a Q-tip or a cotton bud to clean up some little areas. I'm not gonna worry about it. I think it looks okay. Someone says they buff it off with a microfiber cloth. Interesting. Let's see. Anna is asking right here, can you talk about brushes a little bit, synthetic versus natural, big versus small? Thanks. Okay. I like to have a variety of brush sizes. So let me get my drink out of the way and I'm going to pull out some brushes. I have this huge thing of brushes that I keep out on my desk all the time. And I just dropped one on the floor. That's cute. Okay. So if you notice, there's quite a big variety of sizes, but for the most part, they're all pretty small. I tend to use size 2, 4, and 6 quite a bit. And maybe 0 as well. I do flat brushes quite a bit. This one I hardly ever use. I should take that out. Mostly all round brushes, except for those flats that I mentioned. I don't know. I guess it just depends on what you're going to be painting, like on a size of brush that you want. Because if you're going to be painting a lot of big watercolor paintings or big backgrounds, you might want to have a larger brush. But if you're going to be painting really small little stamped images, you might want more small brushes. So I have a wide variety of brush sizes because I've been painting for a long, long time and just add a brush here or there to my collection. What I would do if I was a card maker starting out, I think I would have a couple really small brushes, maybe a 4 and an 8. Maybe 2 and a 4, actually. 2, 4, 2 and 4, and an 8, 2, 4, 8, I'm adding more brushes as I talk. And then I would have a really big brush like this one that I was doing the backgrounds with today, because I think for most card makers these days, you're going to be painting a big, huge background, or you're painting a very small image. So if you have small brushes for small images and a big brush for big backgrounds, I think you're covered. As far as synthetic versus natural fiber, I tend to go more for synthetic or a hybrid blend. This brush from Simon's the Stamp is a synthetic, and I think it works great. The Escada Prado, yeah, I think it is a synthetic. I think that's what that means right there. Can I see that? I think it's synthetic. I'm not entirely sure, but I love the Prado brushes as well. The Silver Black Velvet brushes, let me find one. Like this, I believe, are a natural boar brush. They might even be a hybrid. I don't remember, but all of those are really great brushes. Okay. Someone's asking about branded brushes. Well, I did just talk about those. I would say if you're starting out, I'd go for the Royal Langnickel Zen. And then after that, I would try Silver Black Velvet. Okay. How do you clean your watercolor brushes? Super, super easy. You just swish them in clean water. If your water is particularly murky, like today, mine is pretty murky. Look at that. You can't even see the bottom. It's a green cup. You can't see the green cup. You might have to, like when you dump out your water, you might just have to run your brush under the faucet a little bit. I like to paint with a larger vessel. I have a big, huge bucket over here. Let me show you. Make sure there's nothing crazy in it. There's not. Usually I have this big, huge bucket, and I'll paint mostly out of these two areas. And for the most part, I don't have to change my water at all, because they're such big containers of water, that's like a large volume of water, so it doesn't get too much of one color. It's very diluted because there's so much water. And for that reason, I can usually just clean my brushes in one of those. I just kind of swish it. And this bucket also, I don't know if you can see it. Could you see? Yeah, there you go. You can see down there's like ridges on the bottom. And you can like lightly scrub your brush along the bottom there. And that really cleans it out too. And then just set them horizontal to dry, which generally when I'm using this, it has this handle. And the brushes just sit right there as they dry. And when I do the supply list for this video, I will go ahead and link to that bucket. It is from Mijello. It's fantastic. You can get it at Amazon, at Blick, a lot of different places. Okay. Well, I think I'm going to close up the video for now. Thank you guys so much for joining me. So many of you joined. I'm glad you found me after that previous link was bad. I still don't understand what happened. I like started it. As far as I could tell on my end, everything was good. It never errored out. It never had an issue. I was like chatting and talking and going along for about 8 minutes before I figured it out. I looked over and I saw comments and I was like, what? Because you were all saying, when did she get a start? I was like, I did. I was so confused. So glad we figured this out. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. I will see you guys next Friday at the usual time at noon Mountain Time. If you guys like having these later in the evening lives, let me know, because maybe we can change it to something like this in the future. Maybe it'll be next Friday. Watch your announcements. Thank you for watching. I will see you guys in another video very soon.